In this video, I'm going to help you understand the various job roles that are available to those who are new to the cloud computing industry. So I teach AWS and lots of my students are looking for jobs in this industry. Now, it's really important in the cloud world to make sure that you've got the right skills and experience and that you're going for the right job role for your stage of development. So what that means is you've got to be realistic. You've got to not try and start too high up in the more senior roles because that's going to be really difficult, especially if you don't have experience. So what are the junior roles where you can get started in the cloud world and then move up to those more senior roles over time? So let's have a look. Now, one of the first things I'd encourage you to do is check out this article. I've put a link into the description of this video. Now, this article goes into quite a bit of detail about various roles, and it's not AWS specific either. We talk about some other skill sets that will be very useful to you if you're going to take a career path into cloud computing. So what is there on here? Well, look, as you can see, there's lots of different job roles. Some of them are technical roles, some of them are not. So think about whether you have a skill set that will help you get into a more management position or perhaps as a sales position, that kind of thing. And then there's other roles like technical account managers where you don't really need a lot of experience. It's more about having some technical knowledge and the ability to deal with customers. And if you have those skills, then that's a great way to sort of get into those types of jobs. And they can be your launch path towards more senior roles as you get more experience and more knowledge in the industry. So definitely have a look at that article. Now, I want to go over the AWS certifications and some of the job roles that you can look to when you get these certifications. Now, I recommend everyone starts at the foundational level with the Cloud Practitioner, but you should then go on to at least the Solutions Architect Associate, which is the next most popular certification. And with those two, that really sets you up much better for getting a job in the industry. So what is possible at these various levels? So if you get the Cloud Practitioner, again, this is foundational knowledge. This is the sort of bottom level. It's really your starting point. So it can be hard to get a job with just the Cloud Practitioner. I would recommend definitely getting that Solutions Architect Associate as well. But the types of job roles you might look for would be things like Junior Cloud Engineer, Cloud Sales Executive, if you come from that sales background or you just have good ability communicating with people. Cloud Support Associate is another one. And then Business Development Manager, if you come from, again, some kind of business background, you might just want a IT certification like the Cloud Practitioner to validate your skills in the cloud, but you're more involved with business functions. So you can go into a role where you're a business development manager in a company who's using AWS. And then, of course, Systems Administrator. Now, when you get up to the next level with a Solutions Architect Associate, that's where a lot more jobs are going to become available to you. Technical Account Manager is largely about dealing with customers. So it's helping them out and it's coordinating with solutions architects and other people within the business to ensure that the customer's problems are solved. Cloud Administrator is, I suppose, a step up more cloud focused than the Systems Administrator. We've then got solutions architects. Lots of people want to become solutions architects, but they're usually a more senior role where you have more experience. So you might want to be in the industry in, for instance, a junior cloud engineer and then a cloud engineer role before you move into being a solutions architect. So you get that experience. We've got cloud support engineers and cloud engineers as well. So note that with the cloud support, there's the associate, which is the more junior level, and then there's the engineer, which is kind of the next level up. So have a look for the job opportunities that you can see on job websites. Keep these things in mind and always look at the associated roles and responsibilities, because ultimately these are just job names. It's what you're expected to do and how much experience you're expected to have that really matters. Now, the other two certifications here are more where you're focused on a particular career path like development or systems administration. So if you're a developer, you might be looking for more junior development positions. That could be a DevOps engineer or a cloud developer, data engineer or cloud engineer. Again, the job name doesn't necessarily give away how junior or senior it is. You've got to look at what are the roles and responsibilities and how much experience are they asking for. And then lastly, we have the Sysops Administrator Associate. So this is more for those who want to be involved in systems administration and operations. So in summary, I would say make sure you get certified at least to the associate level. And I recommend getting all three associates if you can. It's really going to help you get into those job roles. Make sure you get lots of practical, hands-on experience working with AWS, even if it's just in your own testing environments. That's going to really help you when you get interviews. And then lastly, look for jobs and be realistic when you're searching for job opportunities. Don't try and look for the big numbers now. You may not get that for your first job role, but it's coming in the future. Just look for ones that you can get into now that have the ability for you to get into the industry and earn some more experience. That's essentially what you're getting from these jobs. You will get paid as well, but you really want to get the experience. So look for jobs where you're going to get some good exposure to the technology, and then you're going to be able to work from there and move into more senior positions in the future. So I hope that helps, and I wish you all the best in your careers.